failed as a quarterback. So I'm trying to express his life. True or false? He broke the
chair. Tom Senior and I were partners. I started working with Tom when Tommy was in San Mateo.
Check, check, check. 1, 2, 3, 4.
bobcat, they might want to power it up on the ground. I know, I've been hiding well, haven't I? That's for some reason, they're still giving me a check every other week. I don't understand. All three, you got it. Okay, thanks. Yeah, I'm with you. Hey, Frank. Want a mic check? Okay, here we are. Mike Leonard playing part of Rachel Polanski. I'm on a fucking mic. Okay.
Rachel playing part of Mike Leonard.
Get behind that camera.
Hi. Oh, thank you. Oh my gosh, you such a good time. Yeah, we went up on Friday and we got back up to Red Eye. Running around the whole time, but it's awesome. Yeah, it's so nice.
Well, that's what we both said. Let's not be too close.
Sounds good. Yeah, like 1, 2, 3.
Thank you. Thank you. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Check, check, check. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Check one.
moments of silence over by the bench in a few moments.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Joining us today. We wanted to take a few moments of silence to remember these two beautiful, beautiful people that lost their lives 2 years ago on this very spot on a day much like today. So we wanted to take 1 or 2 minutes of silence, if that's prayer, or just good well wishes for the families and the friends and the co-workers that have joined us today. Or maybe that's just for resolve, because a lot of people are needing that right now. So we'll take just the next 1 or 2 minutes, please.
Continue to carry this forward, whether that's talking to your family, friends, and co-workers, sharing it on social media. This is what we need to do. The community needs answers. Thank you for coming today, everybody.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
If you haven't done so already, we join you and invite you to pick flowers in the bench.
Muscles.
all them. Poor guy.
I know we already talked with a bunch of people. Would you mind doing one more? Just
sure.
Thank you.
Would you like Tom?
If you both don't mind. Channel 3.
And we are Channel 3.
Yeah.
Sure. Where would you like to be?
What are you thinking? Is right over here okay? Yeah. Thank you. And I know we've talked with you before, but just today.
Oh man. The wall comes down and the blubbering starts.
Oh, that's where I just keep all the stuff. It's a little... Oh my god. I know. You're telling me.
Oh, that one. Lay a wall down. She's like, just take it off. Sorry. It's okay.
Does it get any easier?
Yeah, because you learn how to keep a wall built. Yeah, that's what you do. Because it's
until something happens and it comes crumbling.
Or it sneaks up on you.
Yeah.
I used to have this thing. This is a little bit of humor. At the mall, there was something about old people, and if I'd come around a corner and I saw an old person, there'd be something about it, and I'd start crying. You know, the same for old people. So I got good at knowing that if you see old people spontaneously at the mall, be prepared.
I mean,
that's silly, but
yeah.
But that's what I've learned, all the different possibilities. Yeah.
So tell me a little bit. I know, again, we've talked with you, but just what you guys are doing here today.
We're here today and very thankful that the Metro Parks, the police, the three detectives were here, Crime Stoppers is here, FBI is here, and all these wonderful people are here, and all these news agencies are here, and we're hoping that someone comes forward with a tip. No tip is too small. They come forward, and if they give one tip, it's anonymous, and if it leads to the arrest of the person and conviction of the person who did this, $100,000. And we're just hoping somebody comes forward with just a small tip, just that will steer, you know, people in the right way to look into figuring out who did this.
And why do you think it's important that you keep having these tributes each year? I think Samantha was just saying, we'll be here next year. Why is it important to keep doing this?
We want to keep the story of Kate and Carnell alive so that...
And you don't know what happens through the course of a week, a month, a year. Somebody may have heard something in a bar. They may have... I mean, you never know. People talk. And eventually, if the people that were responsible for this, if somebody does know something, eventually it's going to come out. We need the person that overhears that to call. Even if it turns out to be nothing, we need them to call.
And how do you feel the police agencies have handled the investigation so far?
I think they've done the best that they can, given, the clues, the evidence, and everything else. I know the Metro Parks Police, they're wonderful. The two detectives that were on this case for quite a long time, they're working their cans off trying to...
And they're working every day.
Yeah.
The Metro Parks detective communicates with the FBI. They communicate every day. They work together. And I've met with them many times now and had discussions, and they tell me what they can. Of course, they can only tell me so much, but every day they're working, they're thinking of it and working toward.
Right, but what makes this case unique is the fact that the time of day, no witnesses, no evidence, no gun, nothing.
Some shell casings, that's it.
That's it. I mean, what do you do with that? Where do you go with that?
And at 10 minutes after 5 o'clock on a Tuesday, on a day like this, to have three gunshots that close to the road with somebody in the parking lot doing paperwork, and no one heard a thing, no one saw a thing. It's just unbelievable. It's just, but my feeling is whoever did this is a violent person. And people are reluctant to step forward. someone knows something about who did this, and eventually this person will succumb to violence himself or themselves, whatever, and then the people will be free to come forward.
What has the last 2 years been like for you?
Up and down, up and down, up and down. Because we want to appreciate everything, we want to appreciate each other, which we do more so than ever, because you realize how precious life is and being with each other is. And but when you're high in appreciating, then you realize Kate's not here, and you plummet to the bottom, and then you come up, and then you go down.
And every day there's pieces of Kate that are a reminder who she was, how much she's missed. I know my biggest heartbreak is the grandkids. I mean, they miss her terribly, and I know they've struggled through this because, you know, their mom and dad, you know, they see us, you know, hush hush talking and whispering. They know things, something's wrong. They know what happened to Kate. They don't know any details, but they know she's not with us anymore. She's in heaven, but. That gets me. Okay.
Sorry.
No, don't be. That's, you know, it comes out at times. You know, when you start thinking that, those thoughts, you start thinking that way, it just happens. And it comes in waves.
The first few get-togethers we had, the first few holidays and whatever, we'd get together for a group picture, and you just felt the void of Kate not being there. It was... But it gets to the point where you got to deal with it, you know. Yeah. And we hold her very close in our memory, and we do all kinds of things to remember her. Alex is great at remembering all kinds of the goofy, fun stuff they did. I mean, Alex and I talk every day, and she brings up all kinds of humor and stuff. And she is, yeah. So that's we keep her alive through all our wonderful memories.
Just because I won't be the one editing this, most likely, can you just spell your first and last names?
My name is Kim Brown, KimBrown. I'm mother of Kate Brown.
Tom Brown, TomBrown. I'm Kate's father.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. And I know it doesn't get easier to do these interviews, and I appreciate you guys, you know.
I'm laughing because a friend of Tom's just rolled up. You're gonna fall.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. And enjoy this week. Hello. Hello. Yeah. And enjoy this weekend.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. I'm so glad you're here.
Yes,
thank
of course.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for filming. Yeah. Thank you. Steve.
Marie. Hey.